Oh, hi. How you doing out there? Tie my shoe. Oh, I stopped at a red light, so I can talk and do that, I think. Gotta hurry home. Not that I don't hurry home every time I go home, but I got to be there for the... There's an ant guy coming, and there's surprisingly few ants, I think, to call an exterminator, but they're annoying, and we can't get rid of them. So it's only like... Every time we go into the bathroom, if you haven't been in the bathroom for a while and you haven't killed a bunch of ants, there'll be anywhere from like 3 to 5 ants if you look around in the bathtub, maybe on the sink, maybe crawling all up in the biz of the medicine cab, medicine cabinet. I can't talk right now. I feel like I had a minor stroke at work. Not implausible. So I gotta be there, I gotta let the ant guy in, he's an exterminator. Sounds like a wonderful man on the phone, sounds just like a sweetheart. So, he said he's not in he's not down my way too often, so if he could come over now. And I said, I'll race home, buddy. Good excuse to get out of work, when I did. And, I don't know. I had a pretty down day. Tour Tuesday. This is March 26th. This is the 8th episode of 18D. You're listening to Drive Time. You know, and I'm always thinking, well, just pick it up from here, from this second forward. Pick it up, man. Pick it up and go. You can forget the past. But I just don't know where this anger I have, this anger is inside of me. And like I said, I was listening to David Lynch's audiobook. And early on in the audiobook, he describes this anger sensation as the rubber clown suit of depression or something like that. It's rubber clown suit, and then there's another adjective in there. And it was like, you know, it was like stifling, it was cooking or something in this rubber clown suit. And he described it as, you know, by meditating, he was able to lift that away. And I've been trying to meditate in my own way. I don't know, like, how to do it otherwise. I've been doing it, you know, I've talked about this, but I've been doing it in the shower. So, and I haven't done it consistently, so I'm trying to, like, do it every day this week. Twice a day for 10 minutes. So 20 minutes of meditation, and I'm not... This is going to sound weird, but when you're inside your head, it is, I notice some positive effects of it immediately after. Like, I feel, but I don't know if it's just from, you know, sitting kind of cramped up in a ball. I'm not uncomfortable, but I'm not lounging on the beach either, or like in a cozy bed, just chilling. I'm cramped in a hotel, in my bathtub, on the ground, in Indian style. So, I'm like, it's a tub bath, so to describe it to you, I sit Indian style sideways in the tub bath, because my leg couldn't fit otherwise. It's not a very wide tub bath, so I'm horizontally in the tub bath, so, and I'm facing my back to, there's a window above me, and at night I put candles in there, and it's and I did this morning too, although they don't really do anything for the ambient light, because there's enough daylight when I take a shower that negates that. So I'm in this kind of dark room with warm water rushing over me, and I'm concentrating on my breathing, and I'm trying to imagine a place and just really concentrate hardcore on my, in and out, counting to 10, and I was meddling, you know, I'm working it out, really. I haven't been able to do it consistently, so I don't know what's the best way to do it for me, and I don't know if just kind of doing a mishmash version of meditation has any value at all anyway. But I suppose I need to do it consistently for a week or two. at least at this much time to 10-minute periods. I don't know if 10 minutes alone in one sitting is enough. I'm not sure. I don't know what I'm supposed to feel. And maybe I shouldn't talk about it until I've let it kind of wash over me in a prolonged period. But there's definitely... I have such anger at having to go to a job that I don't like. And not being able to do what I want, and not feeling like I have this, you know, ultimate sense of free will, and feeling like, well, I need to make money, so I need to be at this job. I don't like the job, but I can't look for a better one. I'm looking, but I don't want to trade this job. And it's not a fear of failure. I just know I don't want a job. I know, like, I don't want... The job I want isn't a job. It's you know, it's the ability to create things and somehow turn that into, you know, adequate monetary gains. And so the jumping off point of there is not working for anyone. It's just working for yourself. It's fine. I can do the work. I don't know if it'll turn into any money at all. And that's scary. But, you know, soon I think I have to take that plunge. Because I don't know any other way. I really should start saving. I bought a couple things, and I'm working on this book, and I bought 1,000 stickers, and I'm going to print out 100 to 600-ish copies, depending on, you know, popularity of it. And it's not going to cost me much to print this book. It's not going to cost me much at all. And I'm trying to maybe give it away for free or donations, and maybe I'll break even. My goal is to maybe break even and get rid of some of that, and possibly use that, parlay that into the ability to maybe branch out on your own. It sounds pathetic when I'm talking about it in these terms, but I don't. Me thinking it's pathetic is me, you know, again judging myself via the opinions of people I maybe know. How I perceive that they might may feel about all this. God, I think I did have a stroke. I can't. I'm like another. Like, I'm enunciating words all weird. I just gotta run myself into the ground tonight. I'm gonna try and run 10 fucking miles tonight and just die. I think that's my goal right now. After I talk to the nice exterminator. Either that, I'll eat 9 pints of ice cream and hopefully go into like some sort of sugar-induced coma. I don't know. I have so much work to do. I have so much fucking stupid work to do, and it's just—it's endless. And it's anger, man. It's just not. It's even anger. So even the fun stuff, the work, the supposed fun work. That's just my fucking hobbies, basically. Let's call it as it is. Even that brings me anger. Because there's such bullshit I gotta handle, and that it just fucking seems like it's like just like busy work almost. I'm giving myself busy work. Fuck that. This should be the first project to go, because why even edit these fucking things together? I mean, seriously, we'd be given all the A, B's, and C episodes. I've now. Given the other run of the show, half of my YouTube account is these types of videos. At least I'm not putting them on my blog anymore, so they only exist on YouTube. For crying out loud.